tell me why I was telling you guys that I was 5'7" in my last video. I am not 5'7", but I have lost a few soldiers along the way, and it's full on like.
Okay. Yeah. For sure. I tell her she's sexy. She said, period, purr. It don't matter who you fucking on, baby, cause I hit it first. Baby, I'ma put it to work. I'm just trying to get up on your skirt.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Oh my god, I actually think this might be the best setup I've ever done. It might seem quite simple to you guys, but I've got my mirror in front of me. Obviously I'll have a smaller mirror so I'll be able to see. I've already set out all the makeup that I'll be using, and I just feel very put together and prepared for this video. So let's hope the feeling lasts. If you are new to this channel, please don't forget to like, subscribe and comment, and thank you for the returning subscribers. As always, it's much appreciated, and the returning viewers more than not. But yeah, and I really hope the lighting, fingers crossed, because I'm always talking about the lighting. So fingers crossed the lighting just is consistent throughout as well. But in today's video, as you guys can see from the title, I am going to be doing a makeup routine on acne prone skin. And obviously, for those that have watched a few of my videos in the past, or all of my videos if I'm lucky, then you guys know I have spoken about my acne so many times, and probably too often. I'm sorry if I sound like a broken record, if it's annoying, but it is something that, you know, for those that understand and have acne or had acne, you guys really understand the struggle. And obviously with it being on my face, it is something that's, you know, prominent, and I see it, you guys see it, and yeah, it's something that I have to deal with every single day. So for those that have acne prone skin, whether your acne looks like mine or whether it looks a little bit worse, better, this video is for you guys. So yeah, anyone that's got glass skin, just leave, because we're not there yet. I have been told that my acne looks like freckles, which is such a compliment, but I know it doesn't look like freckles. I wish it did, but it doesn't. And I think, I don't know how everyone else's acne is, but for me, I have really good days and really bad days. And I actually tried to film this video previously and it was a bad day. I had acne and spots that I thought, no, like, these aren't my regular people, these aren't my regular customers. So let me wait until it's a little bit more cleared up, and then we'll try and repeat and refilm this video. So here we are. As you guys can see, I actually have a lot of hyperpigmentation, which is something, again, that makes my acne look a lot worse than what it is. And I think now I would like to think I'm more so dealing with hyperpigmentation rather than active acne. Obviously I'm not going to go into terminologies too much. Obviously if you guys do need, you know, actual advice and, you know, whatever, please do seek professional dermatologist advice and all that sort of, you know, doctor's advice. But this video is simply just, you know, my makeup routine and just a general conversation around acne, specifically mine. But yeah, like I said, I think I would like to think, well, I definitely will say I have a lot of hyperpigmentation. I'm gonna actually zoom you guys in, one second. Okay guys, so now that you zoomed in, you guys can get a better look and overview of my face and the acne that I've got going on at the minute. This is what it looks like. For those that don't know, I'm actually taking tablets for my acne. I have been on tablets before in the past, and I'm on the same ones. They're called limacycline. Again, like I said, I have taken these in the past, but I was advised that you do need to have around 2 to 3 treatments and sessions, should I say, on the acne, just to see a result and a difference. However, after this round, I think I've got, I want to say, around another month or so left on these tablets. If I don't see a difference, you know, after the tablets that I've got left to take, then I'm definitely going to go and get some non-invasive surgery. I think I've definitely, you know, slept on it, come to that conclusion. Also, my mum kindly gifted me a microneedling session as well. I know it's only one, and you do need a lot more sessions to then obviously again be able to see a difference. But if after the tablets, if after the facial, I don't see a difference, I don't see, you know, any clearance, then I'm definitely gonna seek non-invasive surgery and just go for it, because yeah, obviously it's something that I've know, spoken about a lot. It's something that I really do want to stop speaking about. I don't want to keep bothering you guys. And just for my own sake, personally, if I didn't have acne, I would look a lot better. And it makes me look like I'm not clean, and I am clean. So yeah, there's just so many reasons why I want to get rid of my acne and just have clear skin. Also, I do need to mention these poor flowers. These are real flowers, guys. And this is literally what my head looks like when I've got a wig on. I am suffocating these flowers. They are in water, but I'm suffocating these flowers. So I need to wrap up the video for the poor flowers. So before we get started, I don't want to have this in the way for you guys, I really don't, so I might actually put it there, if that's okay. Before we get into this video, I do want to say as well, I have actually already done my eyebrows, just because I can't talk whilst I'm doing my eyebrows. So yeah, I just thought, let me do them off camera. There's nothing that I really do differently. You guys actually have seen me do my eyebrows before. I use the exact same products. I'm still very much on Barry M. I mean, there's no reason why I'm using this, but obviously I've not run out, so I'm just continuing on using it until it goes. It's definitely a lower end product, but it works. I just use this and the colours. The good thing is, I like anything that's like a colour wheel, a concealer wheel or whatever they're called, but just a palette that's got I know it's so dirty, but just a palette that has multiple options. I can, you know, mix and match, just because obviously it works all year round when I'm tanned, when I'm not tanned. It's just really good. So I still use that. And my older sister actually gave me this product. Let me see where it is, because it should be above. Oh, here it is. Yeah, so my sister gave me this product, my older sister. It's from a brand called Il Maquillage. It's again just a concealer. I've got it in the shade, well, it's Ramadan, so we can't be swearing, but I've got it in the shade I'm Fabulous, and I don't really swear anyway, but it's lovely. It's a multi-use it's a multi-use perfecting concealer, and yeah, I absolutely love it. It's quite lightweight but buildable. It's a great colour. And yeah, I use this for the above of my, you know, to conceal the top of my eyebrows. Another thing is, I do want to try and make this video very much like product related, focused, and yeah, like how the Vogue girls do it. So yeah, if you guys are wanting like a proper like in-depth conversation sort of video, I've got many of those on my channel, so yeah, feel free to jump on one of those ones after this one if you are wanting a more serious or in-depth conversation. But this one's gonna be light-hearted. The only thing I can't do is obviously play music, as I like to do in my get ready with me's. But obviously it doesn't matter. And yeah, so as I said, I've already done my eyebrows. I even still definitely much use Got To Be glue. For those that don't know, and for those that are spending so much money on like brow gel and all that sort of stuff, please just invest. And it's not even an investment really, but yes, it is kind of an investment, and it's a cheap, smart investment, should I say, to just get Got To Be glue, spray a little bit on a spoolie, and yeah, your eyebrows last all day. It's easy to get off, easy to apply. It's just amazing, and it's low-key waterproof as well. But yeah, not waterproof as in it won't come off, but as in like if I went swimming, they won't just melt off straight away, and again, even in the hot sun again. So I'm talking way too much. I've not even started anything, and I should really be talking and doing my makeup. But I'm gonna go in with my trusted True Matte Fenty primer. I'm actually running out of this, so don't mind this. I have already washed my face, done my skincare, and at the minute I am switching between using benzoyl peroxide and leaving it on my face and then washing it off, as well as using a lactic acid and niacinamide soap as well. I switch between those two. I'm not really going to talk too much about my skincare routine, just because I actually want to switch it up. Right now I'm not really using products that I'm obsessed with, other than the benzoyl peroxide, that is like a trusted go-to. So now that I've primed, fortunately I don't feel like I need to let this sit for too long. But I will say, there are times when I do apply the primer and then I get like little white, like fuzzy bits. I don't know if that's because of the primer or because of something that I apply underneath it, but sometimes it'll like roll up. I don't know if that makes sense, but yeah, that happens sometimes. And for those that are interested in what sort of skin type I've got, I've actually got normal to oily skin. It's definitely not dry, but it's definitely normal in most areas, but around my forehead, my T-zone, and yeah, my cheeks, not really my chin, but yeah, those are like my oily areas. So yeah, normal to oily skin. So I'm obsessed with Too Faced concealers, clearly, and I actually need to re-up on Butterscotch and Mocha, but I just most recently got Chestnut, because my mum actually My mum actually had this, and my mum's about a shade and a half darker than me, but on the lower end, like most people of colour are, you know, kind of lighter and darker in different areas, and for me I'm a lot darker in my, when, you know, on my lower half and my chin. So I take the darkest concealer, Too Faced concealer, and just kind of like lightly just put little spots here and there. Fortunately this concealer is like really not thick, but yeah, it's thick, it's on the thicker side, which I like, and I actually prefer like full coverage and all that sort of, you know, full face products. I don't know why, not cakey but full face. I've deleted TikTok now as well, I've not had it for about a month or so, but before I did delete it, I saw everyone doing the whole like, are you a high visual or low visual girl, and I can pull off both, don't get me wrong, and in this video I will be doing low visual makeup, but I'm definitely a high visual makeup, like I love my big eyelashes, I love like the sleek eyebrows and all that sort of stuff, like a really sharp look. So that's definitely the sort of person I am. As I said, I can pull off low visual and I'm gonna do it in this video, but I much prefer full coverage, full face, matte, powders, all that. Oh, I've got concealer in my hair. Yeah, I much prefer like all out or nothing. I think I'm like that in general. Like I'm an all or nothing sort of person. Also, I did actually cut off my tails. I don't know if you guys can really tell, and I think one eyebrow might be a bit longer than the other now that I'm looking at it, but I actually cut off the ends of my tails of my eyebrows just to kind of give more like of a snatched look, and especially when I've got like my hair up, like it just looks a lot more like put together, like a facelift. I absolutely love it. I do want to also say I've got the most acne on my cheeks, and there is definitely the hardest to cover up, so I'm actually going to bring the chestnut just a little bit higher up, just because I feel like with it being a little bit darker, it'll kind of like push the acne back, if that makes sense. Just how we do it when we're like concealing and highlighting. It might seem a bit silly, but I think it does something, and yeah. Actually, I'm going to do that, but I'm also going to mix it with mocha just because that's a little bit more my skin tone. Chestnut is a little bit on the orangey side, it's got a bit of an orange undertone. Now, I never used to have like problematic skin on my forehead, but again, I now do, which is very annoying. So again, I just will leave that to sit. And with these concealers, I find you don't actually need to leave them to sit for too long, just because they dry down quite quickly. Okay, so now that it's sat for a little while, I'm just gonna go in and just pat it down, pat it in. As you guys saw, I don't really bring up my concealer to my right underneath my eyes, just because I know I'm gonna put concealer there. And I don't want to have too much product underneath my eyes, otherwise it'll crease or just look quite cakey and just too much. But what I have been loving is blusher. I was going to do bronzer, but I don't really want to. I really want to keep this quite natural. So as you guys saw, I literally just put concealer on. And I just put concealer on where I absolutely needed it. Nowhere, you know, nowhere excessive. So this is actually an eyeshadow palette. But because of the colours and because of how versatile I think it is, I use it for blusher, obviously my eyeshadows, and I don't use it for bronzer, but it could very much be used as a bronzer just to warm up my face a little bit with the lower colours. So I just get like an angled fluffy brush. I really, really love this brush, and I just, depending on what mood I'm in, what I'm wearing, where I'm going as well, will determine what colour I go for. I really like the more peachy browns for like my everyday, and then I go for like the reddies, I go for like the reds and the browns, like this caramel sauce, when it's like either an evening look or if I'm going somewhere that, you know, that's a bit more like full face, full glam. But today, like I said, I'm not really doing anything crazy, so I'm going to go in with pumpkin spice, which is really not going to make that much difference, I know that, but it also will add a bit of colour. Hopefully you guys can see what I'm doing, but yeah, hopefully it shows up like I've applied a bit of product to my face. But yeah, it's just like a really nice, you know, it's just nice. Yeah, I really don't know if you guys can see the difference. I'm sorry if that's made like a drastic difference, but I have actually turned off one of my lights just because I feel like it was looking a bit too orange. With my blush, I do like to add it to the high points of my cheek like bronzer sometimes, but I still very much will bring it to my cheeks. And especially with a colour like this, because it's not making a massive, massive difference, I feel like I can just kind of put it anywhere and it doesn't look crazy. Whereas like when it's the reds and stuff, I will be more specific and precise with where I place them. I'm literally going to the post office. hey, Mr. Postman. Yeah, I'm literally going to the post office because I've got something quite important that I need to send off. And then I'm just going to do my work around the house, edit, work on my book, all that good stuff. And what I like to do, like I'm sure a lot of us do, is add the blusher onto my nose. I love doing that. And then because that pumpkin spice is quite light, I will actually go in with hot sauce, just like a really small bit, just for my nose, just because it's a little bit more, you know, it makes it a little bit more of a difference. And normally what I would do is actually add the blush here, but I think it makes more sense, and I've just done this right now, but I think it makes more sense kind of bringing the blush over my nose, like how it's kind of supposed to be. So that's about as much That's about as much blush that I will do. But I think you guys can see the difference that it has made, and I'm glad I've turned that light off because I was looking crazy. So now I will just go in with a little bit of concealer, and I'm actually gonna use the FM Fabulous Il Maquillage Concealer with Butterscotch. I'm really running out of Butterscotch, so I really need to re-up on this. But again, because it's like a low visual, light makeup day, I'm just gonna put the smallest amount of concealer around my nose. So I'm literally just gonna put the smallest amount. Hope you guys can see. So that's literally, I hope you guys can see, but that's literally how much concealer I'm gonna do. And again, I'm just using Butterscotch just because it's a little bit lighter. And just again, really lightly, just putting the concealer right underneath my eyes. But I am going to leave that to just sit for a tiny little while. I'm now going to go in with some powders, and I'm now using, well, I originally started off on the Laura Mercier, then I switched to the Huda Beauty, but then the other day I was like, I need both. And the main reason why I like to add concealer is just for a little bit more structure in my nose. And because we've still got blush on the nose, again, I just think the two really work together. Why do I think I'm a makeup guru? And I just take the rest of the product like right over to my eye, just for that extra like put together but not doing anything, because there's no product on there basically left, there's no product left really. It doesn't make a massive difference, it doesn't cake my face up, it doesn't make me look crazy, and yeah. Hey, Mr. Postman. Oh, what I have added actually is my little puff. I'm a puff girl now. But yeah, I just pushed that in again on this side. And because I don't have that much product on my face, is why I don't need to pick up that much powder. I just kind of re-up on what I like, what I use, and what works for me. But again, I could change my mind in future because I'm so indecisive. Oh my god, that said, tell me why I was telling you guys that I was 5'7" in my last video. I am not 5'7". I am 5'6". I am a true 5'6". I have actually been measured just last year, and I really don't think it would have changed that much, especially not by a whole foot. No, a whole inch. I did not pass GCSE maths, so don't come for me. But yeah, I am 5'6". I'm not 5'7". No one think I'm 5'7". I'm not. I'm 5'6". So that's it. That's it for the face. The most I will do is just put some setting spray on. This is actually from Huda Beauty again. It's the Resting Boss Face. I love this. It's matte. It's waterproof. It smells really, really good as well. It smells like a perfume, but like, it just smells amazing. It smells so good, and I will just push that in as well, just for the sake of it. And then the last thing I will do is curl my eyelashes, which is something that I wasn't doing for ages, but my little sister is now into like skincare, into a little bit of like mascara. Well, she's allowed to wear mascara, and that's it. So she actually bought eyelash curler, and I was like, oh, like I used to use these in like high school or whatever. And she had two, so she gave me this one. I don't necessarily need to use it because I would say my eyelashes are quite curly and long on their own, but I have lost a few soldiers along the way from wearing my big eyelashes. Not from them, actually, from the glue. The duo glue is so good, so strong, but it is very much lethal in terms of ripping out your eyelashes, in my opinion. And I'm sometimes so lazy where I'll just pull them off and I won't bother, like, you know, lubricate my eyes or anything like that. But I don't know if you guys can see, but my eyelashes by themselves, they don't really need much. I mean, my eyes in general, I don't really need to put on anything. But for the sake of the video, I will put a small coat of mascara on. And like I said, I'm using brown mascara. Again, this one's from my little sister. This one's from Maybelline, and it says, it says true brown, that's the colour I guess. But yeah, you can use any wand, and this is, I've never actually used a wand like this before. The wand is, first of all, quite flimsy, and I've never used a wand that's like really, really small like this, but again, I think I'm going to always resort for a brush like this instead of like the thicker ones, because I think it just separates my eyelashes out a lot better and it looks a lot more natural. And I'm literally just putting mascara at the very end. I'm not going like in and up and in and up. I'm just putting the product right at the end just to kind of pull my eyelashes up. And like I said, because I'm not really going anywhere, there's no point of me putting loads of product on to then have to take it all off again. I feel like on camera you guys cannot tell the difference, but that's it. That's literally all I'm doing. So now I'll just wipe off the little Vaseline. And again, what I put on my lips always depends on what mood I'm in, what I'm wearing, where I'm going. But for this look, I think my actual like lip gloss, just my normal everyday lip gloss, is in my bag. And my bag, I think it's like over there, and I pushed my bed over there, so it's not really accessible right now. So what I will do is, let's see what we've got. These are more like actual going out. So these are like my browns, my pinks. There's not much gloss. I've just got this, so I'll put this gloss on, but this is not my actual gloss that I'll wear. So I'll do like a little nude look. So I'll use this just for, again, for the sake of the video. This is the LA Colour Lip Liner Pencil in the shade Cappuccino. This is like a really nude colour for me. It really doesn't matter even how I place this, to be honest. Like, it's so nude. I'm more like, when I'm using that, I'll use like my actual dark brown, and then I'll put that in the middle and then something over the top. But because, like I said, my actual lip glosses are nowhere to be seen, I'll just do a little wash down. This is not my lip combo, I must state that. This is not my lip combo. But what I do is actually take a lot of, not a lot, but I'll take a lot of the product off. What is that? Well, my camera's beeping. Where is that? My camera was overheating. It very rarely does that. But whilst it was cooling down, I went and got my lip glosses. Again, these are just really basic. These are just like my little everyday ones that I use. And I'm running out of this one, but this one's actually just from Tesco's. This one is from the brand Collection. It says Gloss Me Up Lip Gloss. Again, really, really simple. Just like a pink colour. Yeah, I literally just use this. Obviously, I've already put colour on my lips, so it looks a little bit different, but this is what I'll do. This can be applied without anything. If you want to put Vaseline on underneath, then you can do, but I literally just use that, and that's normally my everyday, you know, everyday. Gym, work, that's my everyday. So I can leave it like this, which looks nice. I got this from London, again, just from a brand called NX Makeup. Lip shine in the colour Cotton Candy, and I go in with this and just put it here. Again, I'm sure on camera it doesn't really make a difference, you can't really see the difference, but I like a good glossy look, especially when I've not got that much face makeup going on. But yeah, as you guys can see, I probably look just like how I should look if I didn't have acne, to be honest. Yeah, so as you guys can see, this is the end result, nothing crazy. I feel like sometimes I'll watch people's, let me move this. I feel like I'll sometimes watch people's like natural glam or everyday makeup and it's full on like, and I'm like, that is not everyday. That is not low visual. That is like a full on, you know, glam going out. which is not a problem, not at all, don't get me wrong. I love that look. But obviously this is my natural look. I class this more so like natural, no makeup. But yeah, I really, really like this look. Like I said, it's something that I will do if I am going to work, or if I'm just gonna go run errands and do want to look more presentable. But again, when I am running errands, I am more so like just in and out. As long as my hair looks good and my outfit's decent and I've got perfume on, I'm not like, you know, going crazy, because yeah, at this moment in time, my acne is something that I just really want to focus on. My skin is something that I really want to focus on. I don't want to put makeup on, because yeah. But yeah, as you guys can see, obviously this is the end result. I am gonna, I'm not gonna link all the products below just because that's not relevant, not necessary. This video was more so just for those that have got acne prone skin, or those that wanted to see how I, you know, sometimes may look in my vlogs, how did I do that, you know, what products did I use. So yeah, again, this is for the those people that wanted to see what I do, for those that have acne prone skin, how do I cover mine, and what products do I use, and yeah, so it was just a quick conversation about those things. And yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy this video because I enjoyed filming it. I hope you guys enjoyed the little setup, and yeah, I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.